I'm out here testing the Canon EF 50mm f1.8 full frame lens on the Sony A7C, and the way I'm doing that is that I'm using the Sigma MC11 mount converter. A couple of immediate observations I've made using a Canon lens on a Sony camera is that the autofocus works on any photography mode, but it does not work on any video mode. You have to pull focus manually. So you can use the autofocus when you're taking a photograph, but when you switch to video, you have to switch to manual mode. Or maybe you don't have to switch to manual mode. You could leave it on automatic, but you still have to pull the focus yourself. Speaking of focus, is this focusing on me? I guess it is now. Anyway, I'm going to continue walking around looking for some interesting things to photograph with this full-frame Canon lens on this Sony A7C. Oh, by the way, I'm vlogging with the Sony A6600. Which is why it's a little bit tighter than usual. So it's vlogging with 18mm on APS-C, which is a 27mm equivalent, or full frame equivalent. And so I've gotten used to that 24mm on the A7C with my other lens. But this is fine. I don't know why everyone says that, you know, anything over 20 is too tight. I feel like as long as you can get your head in the shot, it's okay. There's a nice little alley to shoot some stuff in.
That went off too quickly.
All right, now we got that autofocus working. As you can see, when I first tried to take a shot, I forgot to switch from manual focus to autofocus. But I do see a benefit from pulling focus manually when you're taking video, because you get to play around with the bokeh or whatever, since it is f1.8 on a full frame camera. It's funny, when I'm out here vlogging without a script, I cut off a lot of my sentences just mid-sentence, because I don't know how to finish my sentences. Let's get this building here. Yeah, so I don't know how people can get used to shooting with prime lenses, because you pretty much are stuck with this focal length. I mean, this is 50mm is definitely way too tight for this. I could get the whole building, you know, in this shot on the A6600 at 18mm, but at 50mm, even on a full frame lens, you don't really get much of a shot. So you kind of have to focus on certain details of your subject that you want to get. And I guess in a sense that constraint sort of makes you more creative. But yeah, I'm definitely going to need to practice a lot more, because I'm not used to shooting with primes. Okay, so you just saw one of the caveats with the autofocus, which is if you try to use the spot focus, it hunts and hunts and hunts and sometimes does not find anything. So, yeah, it's just another thing to keep in mind when using a Canon lens on a Sony camera. What else is there to photograph around here? Maybe I should go down to Market Street. It's funny how with that building I had to stand basically clear across the street and even down the street a little bit just to get almost all of that building in the frame at 50 millimeters. So 50 millimeters is definitely a portrait lens. Yeah, so on those last shots, I felt like it was quicker to use the manual focus than it was to rely on the autofocus because I didn't want to wait for the autofocus to keep hunting. I know none of you asked what it's like to vlog at 50 millimeters. This is what it's like to vlog at 50 millimeters and not focus on your face. It's focused on everything else. So look at my bokeh head. I'm just completely blurred out. Now let's see if I could focus on my, I have to pull it manually. There we go. Yeah, that's what 50 millimeters looks like. But look at the background. Look how creamy that background looks. I mean, I know no one would ever vlog this tight. 50 millimeters is really tight, but man, look at that background. Also, 50 millimeters is definitely the most flattering focal length for faces. I could definitely see why it's used for portraits. Okay, so admittedly, I probably should have used manual focus on that train station shot, but got a little lazy, whatever. as tricky as sticking with a prime focal length is when shooting photographs, one thing that I do notice, you know, with the extra aperture or the wider aperture, is that the images definitely do look better in the viewfinder than they would, definitely than they would with my f4 24 to 105 millimeter lens. As easy as that lens is to use, because it's got such a wide focal range. I guess there's trade-offs with everything. You know, with primes you get less distortion, a wider aperture, and with the zoom lens you get more versatility. So the Canon lens-Sony camera combo is not perfect, but it's usable, especially for photography. I guess it's better to use native lenses if you want the best results for both photography and video, but I mean this combo works until, I guess until you're able to afford those really expensive Sony prime lenses or those really expensive G Master lenses. I'm going to get a couple more photographs and then call it a night. Thank you. looks like that Starbucks near the ferry building just packed up and left, and they didn't even take their San Francisco photography with them.